Hello. Today we're going to use one balloon to make a bird, something that looks as a toucan. Inflate a balloon leaving about 5-inch flat tail. The first two bubbles we twist to make the eye bubbles. Let's twist the first about 3-inch long bubble. Now we twist in the second about 3-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first two bubbles in one lock twist. We can secure the knot by pushing the nozzle of the balloon between bubbles. We have made the eye bubbles. The next two bubbles we twist to make the beak. Let's twist the third soft, about 5-inch long bubble. Toucan has very big size beak. That's why we have to make big size bubbles for the beak. Twist the fourth soft, about 5-inch long bubble. Now we have to lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. So far so good. And now we have to lock all ends of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, we have made the beak. The next two bubbles we twist to make the wings. Let's twist the fifth about 5-inch long bubble. Now we twist the sixth about 5-inch long bubble. And we lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the wings. The next bubble we twist to make the body. Let's twist the seventh about 3-inch long bubble. It is the body. The next two bubbles we twist to make the legs. Twist the eighth soft about 1-inch long bubble. Twist the ninth soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. Now we lock all ends of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. This way we have made the legs. And now we twist the tenth about 1-inch bubble. Now we have to lock the free end of the tenth bubble between the fifth and the sixth bubbles. We have to force the end of the balloon through the loop between fifth and the sixth bubbles. The rest of the balloon is the 11th bubble, it is the tail of the bird. We can keep the tail as it is, or we can lock both ends of the 11th bubble in one lock twist. In this example I'm making very small, about nail sized bubble at the very end of the balloon, and then I lock both ends of the 11th bubble in one lock twist. We have made the bird. Here's a side view. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. We can pull the wings slightly apart and force the body bubble between the wings. Here's the front view, the side view again. To make the bird more recognizable, we can use a permanent marker to draw the eyes. I draw big size eyes. You can make just a couple dots or lines to mark the eyes. Let's make some more drawings on the wings. Some kind of feather. Alright, I think this bird looks great. Let's take a look on our bird one more time. Here's the front view, the side view, the top view, the front view again. We can modify this bird in different ways. Let me show you one more sculpture. Inflate a balloon any color, leaving about 6-inch long flat tail. Let's twist the first about 3-inch long bubble. Twist the second about 3-inch long bubble. And now we lock both ends of the chain of the first two bubbles in one lock twist. For the nozzle of the balloon between bubbles to secure the knot, we have made the eyes. Let's twist the third soft, about 5-inch long bubble. And now we lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist. We have made the beak. Next we twist the fourth, about 5-inch long bubble. Now we twist the fifth, about 5-inch long bubble. And we lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. This way we made the wings. The next bubble we twist to make the body. Twist the sixth, about 4-inch long bubble. The next two bubbles we twist to make the legs. Let's twist the seventh, soft, about 1-inch long bubble. Twist the eighth, soft, about 1-inch long bubble. And we lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. Let's lock all ends of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. This way we made the legs. Now we twist the ninth, about 1-inch long bubble. And we lock the free end of the ninth bubble between the bubbles of the wings. Again, we have to force the end of the balloon through the loop of the bubbles of the wings. Here's the side view, the front view, and the top view. Twist the tenth, about 2-inch long bubble. Twist the 11th, about 1-inch bubble. And twist the 12th, about 2-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last three bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the tail. The rest of the balloon is a 13th bubble. You can cut off the 13th bubble or leave it as it is. It's up to you. So as you can see, we have made the bird with a different tail and with a different beak. And now we can use a black permanent marker to draw the eyes, wings, tail, if you like. I draw big eyes with eyelashes. Well, I'm not sure if birds have eyelashes, but I like it this way better. And here are some drawings to mark the feather on the wings. The shape of the beak of this bird reminds me the shape of toucan beak, so I'll call it a toucan. Alright, congratulations again, we have made the bird. Actually, we have made two birds with different tails and with different beaks. Here's a side view. Let me hold it properly. Here's a side view. And here's a front view. This is top view. Well, that's enough for today. Have fun and happy twisting!